What we're going to create today is the bullets and numbering styles that we used in the previous video. We've got the red phone, the blue book, the purple hand for our bullets, and then we've got a numbering style below. The first thing we want to do is create the character style for that red phone that we saw. So I need to go into our styles window and click on the character style. Now I'm going to right click and select new. Our character style dialog box or window appears, and I want to give this one a name. I'm going to say dash, so it goes right to the top of the list. I'm going to call this my bullet style 1. Now the style I want to give it is, for the font, we're going to use New Times Roman. We're going to make this thing bold, and we're going to make it 20 points. We also want to give this an effect color of red. I will use light red. That's what we used last time. Apply. And we don't want to link this with anything. We're going to say none and custom styles. Okay. There's our first bullet style. Now we want to do the same thing for the blue book. So new dash, whoops, my bullet style 2, making this thing none. Custom styles. The font we want to use is Gaudy Stout, italic, and we'll make this 12 points. And the color we want to use is blue 7. And we say OK. And one more. Italic, 10 points. Color magenta 8. And now we have our three character styles created. Now we want to create the bullet list style. So I'm going into the lists tab of our bullets and numbering. And in here is where I want to create our new numbering style. We are going to call this dash to make it go to the top, my bullet style. And we only need one style for all of our three different levels. And we talked about all these tabs before, so now I'm going to the position. I want to make this for my level 1. I'm going to have the tab stop. I'm going to set this to 0.25. We're aligning left. We will align at 0. And our indent will be 0.25. Now we want to go over to our options tab and select what we want for our values for level 1. Instead of numbering, we want to make this thing bullets. Here's bullet. So now we go into our character. And we need to go down to Wingdings 2. Our telephone is right here on the top line. Our character style. This one, instead of the generic bullets, we want to make this one the bullet that we created. So we need to go into My Bullet Style 1. Now we've got My Bullet Style 1 as the character style, and our telephone as the character. Going down to the second level, we basically do the same thing here. We make this thing bullets. Our character style here is going to be 2, and we want this to be our book, which is found in Wingdings 1, or Wingdings, I guess, right here on the top level again. So now we got our telephone, we have our book. We need to go to bullet level 3. Change this thing to bullets, our numbering to bullets. Character style is, and the character, we need to go down to Wingdings 2 again to find the hand pointing to the right. I believe this is it here. Clicking OK. So now we've got our telephone, our book, and our hand. And our hand will be bringing in that purple from our style 3. The book will be bringing in the style 2, which should be the blue color. And when we go to level 1, we should have our telephone, which would be red. So clicking OK. Now we've got the style, we need to create something out there to make our list with. So let's quickly type in a list. It's got a standard list with our different levels, our 1, 2, and 3 levels. Now I just need to highlight this list and double click my bullet style. And now we have our red telephone, blue book, and our purple hand there for our 3 different levels. Thank you.